points and gains, but the underlying, let's say, tide that is rising is the tokenization. Why? Well, tokenization is seen as the new business model. And this is because there are some conceptual things going on right now. There is an emergence of the new users coming to the, let's say, to the place where they are asked for opinion. But before I start talking about tokenization, I will just point out three ideas that we are looking to happen in the, let's say, in this year. One, of course, is regulation. Regulation is already happening. Let's say tomorrow is a special task force meeting of European Security Commission, and they will debate about economy, not economy, but they will about, let's say, crypto economy. They will debate about regulation and how to imply all existing rules to the new, let's say, industry that is coming. Of course, they are aware of the fact that they will not kill the industry. They are aware of the fact that crypto industry, blockchain industry, might be a possibility to, let's say, to get some competitive advantage on the continent size, which means this is a great opportunity for Europe to gain favorable environment, favorable framework, legal one, to have a blockchain industry. And what we saw earlier in presentations, in Slovenia, already 10% of GDP is involved in crypto. Already there are some special meetings on the national, at the national bank level, about the influence and the potential influence to the system. There is quite strong interest from the government. There is a strong interest from the regulators, and this is not just the from the side where it's there are some, let's say, nice informative letters coming from the regulators, but it's really having different people together thinking about how to place something. What we are seeing currently is also that from the regulators there will be a cascade of new development. So what I think personally will happen, that ICO will be declared as the securities. When this will happen, all the exchanges will have to have some kind of license. When exchanges will have license, other assets will come. And this will be some kind of, let's say, a moment where a realization will happen, when old economy will see, oh, a new car is arriving and we have to adopt. And talking from the business perspective, we can see that the platform business, it's not going away. It is getting stronger and stronger. I think thinking about Uber, thinking about YouTube, thinking about Amazon, Apple, and other platforms, we are seeing now they're already taking market shares. And the platform is quite simple business, because it is putting on the, let's say, on the global perspective, attacking local regions. While the old economy was like coming from the local environment, and then if you want to, let's say, address other countries, you have to establish subsidiaries and so on and so on. With the platform business, it's easy. You just set up or develop one platform, and it's easy to, it's accessible, it's understandable, it's easy. It's on the click, click, click. And we are now, let's say, breeding a click, click, click generation. So people are all more or less used to find it in a three clicks. And tokenization as such is emerging. Why? Because of these three clicks, people are always asking themselves, what is it for me? So they are thinking in a way how they will benefit from it. And the token economics answers that question. Why? Because it aligns these interests. it's not just a company for the shareholder, but it's a company, or let's say a project, that brings value to different stakeholders. And these stakeholders are covered or taken care with tokens. And this is something that we will see more and more. Just imagine, because this is the debate when utility token is kicking in, what does it mean in a sense of, okay, I have some utility, is this not a security or is it security? Well, regulators are here really clear. If you are financing your business, either crowdfunding or something else, you're getting a finance for development. And this is, with no other words, it's a security logic. We heard a presentation from the Reinhardt. He was talking about traditional assets being tokenized. Well, the thing here is the driver behind this tokenization is liquidity. Why? Because a lot of assets are now illiquid. We can imagine that, let's say, this hotel, they have two rooms always empty, and this can be tokenized. This can be put in a fractional unit that can be monetized. What that means? Well, it means that with such tokenization, all these characteristics that are aligned with these assets will follow this token. And that will mean that tokens, like asset-backed tokens, some cash streamline tokens will come into the place. Because why? Because currently we are seeing just, let's say, on the level of the crypto industry, we are seeing the platform tokens and then startups covering different areas. And the volatility is coming from these startups. And we know the statistics of the startups. 9 of 10 is fails. So when last week the chairman of the American Security Commission was explaining why the ETFs for the crypto industry are not yet allowed, he was referring to price discovery. Why? Because exchanges are not licensed, and most probably price there might be manipulated, so there is a question regarding the price. Then is the custody, how to keep safe these assets. And there is, of course, volatility. But volatility is more or less connected to the startups. There, you will see all the projects promising heaven, and then every step that is realized, it's already price sensitive information. So what we are seeing at some projects, people are now all the time in front of the camera and doing interviews and doing Q&As and doing ask me anything stuff. Yeah, but who is then building the company? Who is making this realization happening? So this is the thing that it will, in the next, let's say, 1 year or 2 years, that we will see. Let's see just economy. We started in 2016. It was almost 1 year when we opened the platform. So 1 year was just coding. And right now we are in the process of, okay, let's now start the business, start growing. But there are many, many questions how and where we can fail. And I can imagine that these all challenges can be applied to all the ICOs. What I would here point out is definitely the challenges that are coming for the traditional asset tokenization. One, of course, is the regulatory, but here the governance. Let's imagine that you will tokenize one real estate, and 1,000 token holders will be de facto owners of that company. Who will then take care of that real estate? Who will change lamps? Who will collect all the rents? These things are always in real life, let's say, issues that need to be taken care of, and that will need to be also taken care of with a smart contract. Also, there is this status quo situation. why old finance industry, in our case, we are hearing again and again, it's like, yeah, well, crypto is, it's dead, it's dead, it's dead. They are in a status quo. They are not a knowledge, they are not, they are aware that their clients are already moving funds from one, let's say, from mutual funds or from equity to, let's say, to crypto in one part, but they are doing nothing because it's status quo for them. And it will be challenged. And they have power, and most probably they will have a strong voice at the regulatory level. So that might mean that the entry barrier will be really, really high, especially for the finance industry. It will be also interesting to see this impact of traditional asset tokenization on the protocol tokens, which means that you will have, let's say, smart contracts based on Ethereum and coming from every aspect, from different, let's say, from different aspects, ideas, these tokenizations, Ethereum will just grow. There are now many developers already in Ethereum association or in Ethereum development. And this is just a matter of time when the products will come. And we will not even know that something is behind Ethereum. We saw last week, we had one presentation with Slovenian government. There was a prime minister, and there was a showcase of the blockchain used for the identity. And it was just like, when you pick up your ID, the personnel is putting you in the, let's say, in the register, and then you're fine. That's it. So your face is in blockchain. And it's really scary that this is already happening. So Dubai said you will not need passports when you will go through the Dubai airport, because everything will be on the blockchain. Your identity will be on the blockchain. Blockchain means transferring the original. So the original there will be. Talking about the enterprise and coming tokens to the shares, there is one project coming alive soon, Neupoint, German project, and they are saying that they will do tokenization in a way, bringing shares to the token worlds, meaning they will obviously need a license exchanges to list such tokens. But this is happening, and this is happening within 1 or 2 months. So this is really, in one way, really, really beneficial for all, let's say, investors, because at one point they will decide whether it will be just startups or ordinary companies being on the tokens. And just to give you an idea how would that work, imagine that you just coded a blockchain protocol, give every shareholder a token, and then this token represents ownership. And then you decide, hey, what about our users? Give them also some tokens, because they are generating the content, or they are creating the value. Imagine the Facebook. Imagine that every user who is posting on the Facebook gets one Facebook token. More is active, more he gets. And then on the other side, there is the ad agencies wanna buy that tokens because they want to advertise on the Facebook. So you have a perfect solution. And then you ask yourself, okay, what about the shareholders? Yeah, well, let's imagine that shareholders get one part of those tokens, because looking at currently structure of the ICOs, we see that there is, let's say, 50% of the structure of the whole tokens goes to the distribution to investors, and 50 goes something to team, something to early investors, something to advisors, future team, and so on. So imagine such structure will also apply in let's say, when old economy chooses to go into that direction. And then it is always the question about the governments and the power. So who will be then deciding what is important for the company? And this power will just be like the centralized idea will be just melting. So it will be melting to the community. So what is next? In my opinion, we will see quite interesting development on this side. Because currently, the investor base, we saw from Menon, these are the small retail investors. And these investors in cryptocurrency never, most probably, they didn't bought any shares. So they didn't bought any equity or bond. These are people with 10, 20, 100 euro investments. Looking at our company, at our project, and going or just analyzing the transaction on crypto exchanges, you can see what are the numbers. We are seeing transactions like 5 tokens traded. 5 tokens of economy is like 5 euros or 7 euros. So imagine that kind of money traded on a traditional stock exchange. No way. And this is the new investor base that is coming to the team. And when ICO is happening, these investors are buying. Not yet institutional one, they're coming. They're waiting for the regulation. They're waiting for the rules to be set. But already we are seeing this investor base. And just to give you an example, why tokens will survive, because these new investors, they will ask old investors, how come when you are selling an equity, why are you waiting 3 days for the settlement and money? This is no logic. And what if I choose to, let's say, jump from Japanese equity to American equity? Why is this taking me really, really long time? And this is something that tokenization will answer. Startups are really the first wave. And now it is coming stablecoins and asset-backed ICOs, and they will be followed by the old, let's say, or established companies. And also financial instruments will migrate toward token characteristics. What that means? Even now, regulated stock exchanges are already asking how to set up a specific tier for the tokens. And here is now the question. Will they succeed with this challenge to set up a special tier for the tokens, or will the, let's say, new crypto exchanges just become regulated faster than that? So we will see here this fight between exchanges, who will be the first. Because at the Binance case, we saw in 6 months, you can grow really big. Binance in December had 5 million users, and they closed the door for new users. When they opened it for 2 or 1 hour, there were more than 200 users in with the application. And in January, at Bitstamp, as one of the oldest exchanges, there were more than 600,000 users waiting for the to be processed. So they are really big numbers. And this is why it's so easy, because you can do it on your couch, on, you can do it in your living room, undressed, just with a mobile, ID identification, yeah, that's it. So with the ease of the user experience, this whole idea of crypto is just, what it will just emerge with the world economy. What we will see is, of course, new governments. Why? It is already a knowledge between the crypto industry that ICOs in term of the scams are doing more harm than the benefit for the crypto industry. Our prime minister said, we support. We will do whatever it is needed to do. But if there will be one, let's say, fuck up, everything is down. You will lose credibility, trust, and you will be, you know, in real problem. So as an industry, we have to, you know, educate ourselves, look each other, and just level up the standard to the level where everything works fine. This is like an idea that is happening right now behind, and we will see many let's say new projects, new ideas coming and covering this topic. And now, of course, just a short info about economy. So we did ICO in 2016. That was one of the largest ICO in Europe back then. Just to give you a feeling for that, we got 200,000 ethers when we did ICO, plus many bitcoins, plus many lists, plus many euros, because that was in time also possible to do. Currently we have 50,000 users, but these are not ordinary users, because they have to open the wallet on the exchanges and come and transfer the digital assets to our platform. So they need to know something about the, let's say, buying and selling digital assets. Of course, that number will grow when we will introduce fiat, so the easy way how to access our platform. Our core focus is, on one side, we are offering people to be exposed to digital assets in an easy way, but on the other way, we are also the platform where people can create their own structures. So this is the thing where, you know, fund management industry, it's not more, let's say, just limited to, let's say, professional investors, but also to the people around the globe. Currently, we are not open for the US citizens, but, you know, going forward, the platform will grow, new features will be introduced, and just to give you an idea what we do in a core, we are now taking care of four pillars. We do back-end administration for the structures, we do storage, and we do execution. And fiat ramp-up is coming. So basically, this is economic platform. And when you are thinking about having a portfolio of 20 different digital assets on 5 different exchanges, well, good luck when something is up and down and you want to change something. Because we saw in December what happened when some APIs dropped and some exchanges were not accessible. So this is more or less from our side. And now I would really invite all speakers to join me at this short panel where we will discuss and try to answer all your questions. I heard that some of the topic was, like, say, beginner level. So I expect some, let's say, more deeper questions that we can address. So thank you very much.